ولكن تحديت الظروف وخضتها وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى محنتها، وكم كرهت مصابها.
Now the white paper, the rulers and the super Salafis try to use the next quote to say, oh, but look at this. But what they don't know is they shoot themselves in the foot when they try to use this. As you can see on screen, okay, it mentions that using this and similar statements like it, a group among the Mu'tazila also go with this view. It is also the view of the Khawarij. Now we ask you this. You go, look, oh, but this was the view of the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij. Okay, so that's the case. Let me ask you a question now. And it's just poor they even try to use this, but they're desperate, you see, they're desperate. They're, you know, their foundation's been shaken, they're panicking, they're in frantic mode. They go, oh, bloody hell, I just exposed this. But look at this. Technicalities, you know, childish technicalities. Okay, so we ask this. Using this and similar statements, okay, like it, a group among the Mu'tazila, extreme rationalists, also go with this view. It is also the view of the Khawarij. So the Khawarij use this view. And the Mu'tazila, they also go with this view and similar statements. That they use this, sorry, using this and similar statements. So did the Sahaba have Khariji tendencies then? Did the Sahaba and the Salaf al-Saleh have tendencies of I'tizal? They had the tendencies of the Mu'tazila because using this and similar statements. So the Sahaba used it, the Salaf used it, the Salaf al-Saleh used this, but the Mu'tazila and the Khawarij used it as well. Now, the difference is, they did this to forward or to proceed with their deviant beliefs. So even though they use these Quranic ayahs to further their misguided agenda, the Salaf al-Saleh also used this, but they did it with truth. They did it with haqq. They did it with, you know, using the correct understanding. The Mu'tazila and the Khawarij, when they use these verses and similar verses to it, they were upon batil. So I ask you, if you're going to use this and defend your position by saying, oh, but look what Ibn Abdul-Barr said. So did the Sahaba have Khariji tendencies then? Because the Khawarij used these verses. And the Khawarij used these similar verses as well. And the Mu'tazila used these verses. So the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum and the early Salaf that did Rubal, they had Khariji tendencies and they had tendencies of I'tizal of the Mu'tazila. You wouldn't agree, would you? You would say, no, of course not. That's the point. That's exactly what I'm saying. So you can't use this statement. So the Salaf did Rubal and they used the Quranic ayat. Let's carry on and carry on reading. And listen to what Ibn Abdul-Barr says. He goes, but as for Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah and their scholars, they say the leader must be gracious, knowledgeable, just and have a strong personality. If this is not possible or if not found, it is better to obey the unjust ruler than to rebel against him, because rebellion replaces security with fear. It causes bloodshed. These calamities are greater than being patient with the oppressor. So there you go. Ibn Abdul-Barr in his Al-Istithqar.
Now, following on from the accusations hurled at me in connection to distorting or even misquoting Imam Ibn Abdul-Barr, rahmatullah alayh, Shamsi also tried to play the same distortion and technicalities, trying to obviously blind his gullible followers, his sheep. Now, Ibn Abdul-Barr confirms that obviously similar statements were used by the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila in connection to this. And as we know, the Salaf used it as well. So as I argued, all right, then if you're arguing, oh, look at this, then the Salaf and the Sahaba, or rather the Sahaba and the early Salaf, had Khariji tendencies, because the Kharijis or the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila used these verses as well. Now, Shamsi, and as you'll hear, tries to argue the same with Imam al-Qurtubi, because Imam al-Qurtubi quotes Ibn Abdul-Barr, if not identical, adding a few little, you know, phrases here and there. But we'll play Shamsi and we'll also obviously show you that I haven't misquoted anything, rather that even if the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila did use it, which they did, we don't deny that, did the Salaf and the Sahaba, or the Sahaba and the Salaf, have Khariji tendencies? Have a listen.
Then al-Qurtubi goes on to say, والذي عليه أكثر من العلماء الأكثر من العلماء أن الصبر على طاعة الإمام الجائر أولى من الخروج عليه. What is the opinion of majority of the scholars? That is better off to hear and obey the leader. نعم, and to be patient upon that. نعم, to be patient upon that. Sorry. أن الصبر على طاعة الإمام, yeah, to be patient upon obeying the evil leader and the oppressive one. Why? Because when you rebel against him, is the outcome, the outcome of it will be corruption upon the earth. But the end of it is said, والأول مذهب طائفة من المعتزلة وهو مذهب الخوارج. Hajji, why you left this one? Why you left it? Qurtubi is refuting you. He's telling you the statement of those who say that the oppressive leader should not be heard and obeyed is the madhab of al Khawarij and Mu'tazila. So it's not madhab al Sunnah.
Now the irony is, subhanAllah al-Azim, Shamsi accused me of misquoting, and as the title of the video, which this video is who is really misquoting, bro Hajji, self-incrimination, etc. It just shows, after what you just listened to, and how what he read in Arabic and how it translated it, beggars belief. And then we'll get to his, obviously, accusations as well. So what we'll do is we'll put another block end and a dead end to Shamsi's distorted technicalities. Once again, he tries it. And this is over a year later, but I haven't had time to go around and watch all his videos. And I'm not going to do it. It's just this one. I want to put another dead end to his, evil technicalities and toxic technicalities. But we are going to expose him on other things as well. Not personally, but his methodology, because that's what it's about. He's just a nobody. So let's just go through all of the quotes of Imam al-Qurtubi and we'll read it in context. Not like Shamsi with his mistranslations. We're going to present it all. Okay, so let's read. So first of all, Imam al-Qurtubi rahmatullah alayhi says, "Istadalla jama'atun min al-ulama bi hadhihi al-ayat." That a group of ulama uses ayat, which is in Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that my covenant to Ibrahim alayhi salam, my covenant does not extend to the wrongdoing people. So they, the jama'atun min al-ulama of al-sunnah, said that the imam should be just, have goodness, have virtues with power, and he should establish it. And this is who the Prophet alayhi salam orders not to relinquish our right to. Okay, etc. Then he says, as for the people of sin, tyranny and justice, or tyranny and oppression, that they are not of those, meaning of those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the Prophet ﷺ told us to not relinquish our right to, because they obviously are not of those group of people who we have a covenant with of justice. So he says, Imam Qurtubi said, وَلِهَذَا, because of this, خَرْجَ ibn Zubair وَحُسَيْنُ بِنْ عَلِي رَضِي اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَخَرَجَ الْخِيَارُ الْأَهْلِ وَخَرَجَ الْخِيَارُ الْأَهْلِ الْعِرَاقِ وَعُلَمَاؤُهُمْ عَلَى الْحَجَّاجِ. And this is why Hussein رضي الله عنه did خروج ibn Zubair and the best of the ulama of Iraq against Hajjaj, and those who removed Bani Umayyah from Medina and established خروج against them, and what happened with Harra, etc. Now, this is where we're going to get to the point that Shamsi tries to obviously use as his base. So he mentions that as for the majority of the ulama, as for the majority of the ulama, Ahli Sunnah wa Jama'ah, the sabr against the oppressive ruler is better than doing khuruj against him. Why? Because rebelling against him replaces security with fear, that spills blood, etc. And then he mentions that there's a potential that gharat, that, you know, raids can happen to the Muslims, and fasad is split on the earth or has spread on the earth. Then he says, "Wa awwal al madhab al ta'ifa min al mu'tazila, wa huwa madhab al khawarij." That the first madhab, okay, were the group of the mu'tazila, and then this was the madhab of the khawarij. Notice. So now we ask the question. Yes, we agree that was their madhab. They used to rebel. Okay, used to rebel, make takfir and rebel. Khawarij did that, and the Mu'tazila had that principle as well, that they used to rebel against their rulers. That was their madhab. So what we ask is, if that is the case, what did Imam al-Qurtubi mention? The group of the ulama extracted from this ayat. So the ayat that they used to confirm that the right of the hakim or the wali al-amr or wulatul umur is that they have to be just. Okay, they have to be just. And as for those who are sinners, etc., they are not from them. And that's why Ibn Zubayr did khuruj. So they used that verse. Do you understand? Now, even if it was the madhab of the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila, which we don't deny, what we ask is, because Ibn Zubayr and Hussein radiallahu anhu and what happened in Harra, and what happened with the people and the ulama of Iraq, not juhala, ulama rebel. So now we ask him, did all of them have khariji and tendencies of i'tizal, meaning they were from the Mu'tazila, or not from the Mu'tazila, but they carried their tendencies, and they carried the tendencies of the Khawarij? You have to accept that. You can't have it both ways, Shamsi. You can't say, but look at this, the ulama did it. It was their madhab. So what would we argue? We would argue that no, even if it was their madhab, so what? The ulama of Iraq, the tabi'un, and the salaf, meaning the sahaba as well, use the Quranic ayat. So they didn't follow the madhab of the Khawarij, and they didn't follow the madhab of the Mu'tazila, because when they did this, they used this ayat and various ayats, as Imam Ibn Abdul Barr says, similar statements, to forward a batil aqidah and their batil manhaj. Whereas when the ulama of the Salaf and the Sahaba and various others, meaning from Ahli Sunnah wa Jama'ah, did it, they did this with the correct understanding and to spread justice. And because justice is obviously what we have been commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spread. So, Shamsi, again, you could use this. All you got to now do is just say, yeah, the Sahaba radhanhum and the early Salaf had Khawarij tendencies and that tendency of i'tizal. That's the only solution for you, because that's what you're arguing, mate. So that's a quick video, just to let Shamsi know, mate. You can't try it with me, son, because I'm not going to keep responding to you. We've got many other projects to do. And at the end of the day, I've utterly embarrassed you and utterly exposed you. That's why we had 5, 6, 7 different other people trying to get involved. And again, they've embarrassed themselves as well. So the tide is changing. The people are waking up to your nonsense. You tried it 20 years, 2 decades, down the pan. Your foundations have been shook. So look after yourselves. Wait for the next one. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad. كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أساه حتى وكم كرهت مصابها لكن رأيت الخير يسكب في أنا كم مرة قد ذقت من عظم البلاء بشر وشيطان يحاصرني أبا كم مرة قد أظلم الدرب ضحى وتحدر الدمع وضاقت بي رؤى كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أساه حتى وكم كرهت